Thank you, RJ. Professor Richard Dasher from Stanford University. Mr. N. Lee, head of Asia Pacific. Nicholas Xi, Startup Chile. John Fitzpatrick, Amazon Web Services. To the movers and players in the startup ecosystem, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am deeply privileged to welcome all of you to Slingshot Manila 2015. I extend our sincere thanks to the Department of Trade and Industry, DTI, in inviting the Department of Science and Technology to this very timely and important event. I would like to welcome our partners in the different APEC economies. For everyone, I would like to thank for your presence and our prominent speakers who came from different parts of the world to share their knowledge and expertise to budding innovators and entrepreneurs. Our sincere gratitude to all of you. Current and potential contribution of technology-based startups and techno-entrepreneurs to the country economic development cannot be overemphasized. They develop and deliver high-value technology products and services for the global market. These are the people that start small, have amazing ideas, and march on even when faced by great challenges and uncertainties. The Philippines, as we know, is one of the fastest growing economies in Asia. According to the Philippine Startup Report, initiated and authored by Mr. Ron Hobbs, who I hope is attending, our innovation ecosystem contributed to the country's potential of becoming a startup hub. This is truly an awesome news, because this is what the government, our government, has been striving for with this initiative these past few years. The basic rationale of all the programs of DOST is to enhance science and technology ecosystem to support our industry and SME in improving their productivity, and to support innovators to develop new products and services. Innovators are critical for sustainable economic development for inclusive growth. And to all the innovators, we value your presence and your ideas. Today, I would like to show you why it's not only more fun in the Philippines, but why this could be also the best time to invest your efforts, talent, and money for starting tech businesses in the country. Let me show you how your government, our government, has promoted an SMT ecosystem to support innovators like you, helping you translate and convert your ideas into real products and services which you can offer to the world. Ladies and gentlemen, let me start by sharing a story about a guy I met maybe 1 or 2 months ago. His name is Dr. William Harding. And who is William Harding? He is a U.S. citizen, accomplished in the field of power test equipment and devices, who even sat as the chair of several U.S. standard committees. He is a certified and a serious innovator. But a few years ago, some of his American friends started calling him another name. They call him crazy. Crazy for risking of putting up a tech business of all places, the Philippines. The question is, why the Philippines? He has started several successful startups in the US, but 2 years ago, he chose to invest in a startup here, there in Cebu, because according to him, he was impressed by the Filipino engineers, by the quality of their work, whom he has met in his line of business, and was eventually convinced to put up shop where the talent are. Dr. Hardy's vision is to create a company here in the Philippines that might become a world leader in the design and production of specialized power testing equipment for the emerging electric vehicle market. The initial product produced by his startup was impressive. The device can measure and test with great accuracy the amount of power delivered to electric vehicles. What made our discussion more memorable is that I learned that his idea and suggestion for an innovation ecosystem is not much different from what we are doing. Just like everyone here, he too encountered challenges while setting up business in the Philippines. You can feel the heartaches as he spoke on how he started. Understandably, for a foreigner like him, the learning curve was much deeper and costlier. But he stayed on. Soon, he learned how to access support from government, and later, he realized that even the very core of his business, the human wealth, was a result of a serious government program that seeks to develop critical mass of highly skilled technical and scientific talent and make it available to industry and startup like his. His company required highly skilled software and hardware developers. He has mentioned over and over again that he was impressed by the young engineers he worked with and eventually partnered. No wonder he was impressed, I found out that they were DOST scholars. For the information of everyone, the DOST undergraduate scholarship program grants scholarship to deserving students who pursue science and technology careers. Since 2010, the Aquino administration recognizes the need to boost the pool of highly skilled human resources, has increased budgetary support for engineering and science scholarship. Since 2010, the government has tripled its scholarship, meaning 300%, more than 300%, for undergraduate science engineering degrees. I'm sure that in this very gathering there are scientists and engineers that possess the distinct DOST mark. Moreover, your government continuously supports high education and learning in order to attain our goal of achieving the critical mass of master and doctoral degree holders on areas in science, on priority areas in science and technology. Through the different programs of the DOST, such as the Accelerated Science Technology Human Resource Development Program, the Engineering Research and Development for Technology Program, and the Capacity Building Program in Science Education, we currently now have a total number of 1,112 for masters and 466 for the doctoral program degrees. And we are committed to increasing, to expand this more. The DOST also starts its campaign in manpower development as early as high school education to the DOST Philippine Science High School that has begun to expand all over the country. In 2010, there were 9 PSI campuses. Now there are 13, wherein the 14th is being established in Batanga City, and before the year 2016, there will be 16 campuses. The Philippine Science High School is now recognized as one of the top science high schools in Asia, in this region. Besides the institutional approach to training and learning, we have opened up other programs for specific skill sets required by industry, such as our training program for computer control or CNC, machine to programming operation. CNC machinists and programmers and operators highly in demand in the industry. For electronics, on the other hand, the DOST has, together with the University of the Philippines, established the Philippine Institute for Integrated Circuits that offer integrated circuit design training, microelectronics education, and certification programs for engineers who want to pursue a career in microelectronics. PIIC is a response of the new STP to growing demand for skills and talent in IC. Going back to the challenges of Dr. Hardy, he mentioned that while he was impressed by the Filipino talent, he was disappointed with the lack of facilities that can help him and other startups to develop prototypes. According to him, he has to send the design to the US to have it prototype and tested. How many startups like you could have similar or same problem? You have great ideas, but transforming this into products seems insurmountable, where the only choice you have is to go abroad, just like Dr. Hardy. The DOST realized this gap, this problem, a few years back. The DOST has invested in a world-class facility that can assist companies and startups on specific areas, among them the EPDC, or the Electronic Product Design Center. The EPDC oversees them in terms of electronic circuit design and simulation, printed circuit board prototyping. Currently it's four-sided, eventually it will be eight-sided, testing, and offering them at lower cost, and of course they will be locally accessible. It would mean that Dr. Hardy and similar would not have to go access facilities abroad for their ideas to be translated into working models. The EPDC, which we are launching, is coming July 14, 2015, will open services to the electronics companies and startups. It includes also testing, among them compatibility testing and reliability testing. We also have a testing laboratory that offers analysis needed by the semiconductor and electronics companies. This is the Advanced Material Testing Laboratory, or ADMATEL, situated at UST Bicutan, and is equipped to do failure analysis, thermal and high-resolution imaging and analysis, wherein before the samples have been tested abroad. We have a new program called One Lab, where you can access any type of testing being offered by our network of laboratories, even tests only available in Manila, wherein even if you are in Tuguegarao, Cebu, or somewhere. We are doing this on food, but we expand through the years to include tests that are non-food. We have an upgraded die and mold solution center to service the molding needs of small companies, and we are strengthening our regional metrology laboratory services around the country, especially in Bicutan. You can visit our office or our website to know more about programs and services that is appropriate to your needs. For this reason, we would like to invite you to all the innovators present today. Please visit, find time to visit the DOST compound in Bicutan. There you will find our newly minted facilities that I mentioned earlier, the Electronics Product Design Center, the Philippine Institute for Integrated Circuit, the ADMATEL, the Die and Mold Solution, and other state-of-the-art facilities. Please visit our facilities, and more important, to talk with our expert and how they can be of assistance for developing your innovation. We have also support for innovation in other areas. We have our nanotechnology program to support for you who are interested in developing new materials. We have also our genomics program for those innovators who would like to develop genomic-based or DNA-based diagnostic and other applications of genomics. We have our biotechnology program. We have our advanced manufacturing program and others. Again, To know more about how DOST can support innovators like you, I take this opportunity to invite to join our celebration of the National Science Technology Week at the SNX Convention Center. This year's theme is very appropriate: a science nation innovating for global competitiveness. This will happen on July 24 to 28. Please check our website www.dost.ph and also www.pilipinas.science.ph for your guidance. Let me go back to the story of Dr. Hardy. He actually approached us with a sincere purpose of helping startup, helping ecosystem, improving our ecosystem to help startup in the country. For him, an equally important component in the innovation ecosystem is establishment of technology business incubators. Business incubation is one of the strategies of the DOST promoting innovation and entrepreneurship. It involves providing technology-based businesses mentorship, space, and technical assistance which startup companies need. We now have 5 technology business incubators strategically located in several parts of the country, catering to the different sectors and areas of science and technology. We are poised to establish our 4 more TBIs in the coming years in response to the demand of more regions for nurturing their startups. A proud addition to our incubator facility will be the establishment of 2 innovation hubs in partnership with the Ideas Space Foundation and the University of the Philippines. This partnership with Ideas Space makes the hub to go full circle, signaling the role of government, academe, and private sectors, startups exploring new ways of advance science and technology and innovation in the country. The innovation hub completes the innovation ecosystem wherein startups transform their ideas to products, where investors, angels, and venture capital providers explore novel ideas, where even the scientist takes part in investment decision, and where investors build businesses on science-based application. It will be a venue where science and business converge and propel innovation. After all of this, you must be wondering what happened to Dr. Hardy. A true believer on the potential of the Philippines as a hub for innovation. We invited Dr. Hardy to be one of our advisors. It is our policy in the DOST to involve innovators, the private sectors, and startups like you to vet our future programs on how we can enhance it more as a support for you. Our other assistance for innovators and startup companies include assistance for patent application, funding assistance for development and prototyping, funding support for startup businesses, especially if your product or application is in line with the priority R&D program of the government. In ending this message, I would like to commend the DTI for its effort in making the event a reality and inviting APEC economies to also consider supporting local startups and locating startups in the Philippines, given the support and facility offered by both DTI and DOST. I'm certain that Slingshot Manila 2015 will only be the first of many more the government undertaking to support not only the Philippine startup community, but also our partner communities in the APEC. I hope this conference has opened and will lead to new doors and opportunities. It's not very far behind when startups will undoubtedly be the primary movers of the APEC in the future. Therefore, if we fix the gaps of startups, today, tomorrow, they will be our SME and the future, the core of our business and our economy. Thank you and maraming salamat po sa inyo.